Please do not use flash photography during the concert. Thank you.
Well said. Thank you. All right. So my name is Logan Santiago. I'm the orchestra director here at C.M. Wilton Wright. And the group on stage right now is our 9th and 10th grade orchestra. So the theme for our concert tonight is water, and so hopefully you'll notice a common theme in a lot of these pieces. All of them are about water or somehow relating to water. Tonight we will be taking donations for the Chesapeake Bay Foundation. It's really cool as musicians to be able to use our talents to better our community, so that's what we're doing here tonight. So we hope you will consider donating. You'll hear a little bit about the Chesapeake Bay and the Chesapeake Bay Foundation tonight from some of our students. So I hope that you enjoy that. The piece you just heard was Hornpipe from the Water Music Suite by George Frederick Handel. The piece was written in 1717 and commissioned by King George I of Great Britain. And it was to entertain guests for a royal cruise that he was planning. And so because it was going to be performed on the water, that's why they called the suite Water Music. And a hornpipe is also a sailor's dance, so it kind of fits with the water theme in two different ways. Our soloists for that piece were Carly Gaynor and Thomas Dragunas. Can you guys stand up, please? All right. Our next piece that we'll be performing is called The Old Boatman by Florence Price. Florence Price was an African-American woman born in Little Rock, Arkansas in 1887. She was the first black woman to have her music performed by a major American orchestra. It happened to be the Chicago Symphony. So that was very, very exciting. This piece is very lyrical. It was originally written for Florence Price's piano students. And the arranger of this piece liked it so much that he decided to transcribe it for orchestra. So there are two soloists in this piece, Carly Gaynor and Brandon Stepp. So please enjoy The Old Boatman.
Thank you.
All right, our final piece from this group, the 9th and 10th grade orchestra, is called Isle of Skye, which is an island in the Inner Hebrides of Scotland. It's a beautiful area, gorgeous cliffs, surrounded by water, just beautiful. So this piece is heavily influenced by Gaelic music, the music of Scotland. So it's in a 6-8 feel, so you feel this kind of, this lilty dance sort of feel going on. I don't know if any of your students told you, but I like to do Irish dance as a hobby. And so I did a little bit for them on St. Patrick's Day. So I really like this piece because it reminds me of that a little bit. I think that's all I have to say. So please enjoy this piece, Isle of Skye. In which case you should stay on stage. While they are moving, moving. I would like to bring up Kylie Johnson to talk to you a little bit about the Chesapeake Bay.
I'm going to talk a little bit about how the Chesapeake Bay affects all of us and how the health of it. So the Chesapeake Bay's ecosystem impacts the quality of the air we breathe, the water we drink, and the food we eat. The bay's wetlands protect communities from extreme weather conditions such as flooding, erosion, and storm surges. The bay is also an important economic resource to our community, from the seafood we consume to the tourist attractions we love. The bay also provides many jobs and helps bring in revenue that boosts our local economy. Thank you.
Right, so the group you see up here is the Chamber Orchestra, and they're going to perform a piece for you called Themes from the Moldau, which is a piece by Vedra Smetana from the Czech Republic. Sorry, my breath, I had to run and get my violin. I forgot I was playing. Anyway, this is one of my favorite pieces, just in general. He wrote it to commemorate his homeland. It was during a time of nationalism, and so he used some imagery and themes from the Moldau, which is a river that runs through the Czech Republic. He depicted the rapid section of the river. As you're cruising down, maybe you see a country wedding going on. You see an old castle. There's a legend of water nymphs playing in the trees or something. I don't know. But it's beautiful. And so I was really privileged when I was in high school. I got to go on a trip with American Music Abroad, and I got to actually see the Moldau. I got to actually take a dinner cruise on the Moldau, and my high school director, who was there with me, he loved this piece and he told me about it, so I appreciate it when I was in high school, but not as much as I do now, or as much as he did, because he had his earbuds in the whole time, he had his little pocket score out, and so as we were going on the river, he was like trying to spot all the things that were going on. He was like, "No one talk to me," and of course I was like, "Hello, what you doing over there?" But now, oh my gosh, I would kill to have that experience again. So it's really exciting to be able to share one of my favorite pieces with this group. If you will hold on for just a moment, I actually forgot to grab my music for this piece, so I'm going to run and go get it, and then we're going to play. So why don't you guys... forgot to tell you, the Chamber Orchestra up here, they meet after school. They rehearse on their own. It's made up of 9th through 12th graders, and the whole point is that I don't conduct them, so that's why I'm playing with them. So they really work on being able to lead each other and all of that kind of stuff. So that's what you'll be able to see here today. Here's Themes from the Moldau. Sorry for the delay. All right, up next we have another small chamber group, kind of a quartet with a soloist. So this is Symphony Espanol. This piece for, we're going across the ocean, that's our water connection for this one, because I couldn't think of a better one. So we're crossing the ocean to all the way to Spain, but the composer of this piece was actually a French composer, which is a little bit funny. So he's practicing exoticism, which is taking themes and melodies from a country that is not your own, and then creating a piece sort of based on that. So, let's see what I have to say. Oh, so this piece, we're featuring senior Amelie Marasigan. Amelie, wave. So, as you all know, the past few years have been pretty crazy. A lot of opportunities to perform were canceled. This is actually my very first spring concert at St. Milton Wright because I've never got to do one before because of COVID. So, very excited to be here. But Amelie actually in 2021 made All State Orchestra, which is a very, very big deal. You audition, and so she's one of the best in the state, which is something to recognize. She never actually got to go to Allstate. She auditioned, and they never actually held the festival. So I thought this would be a good way to recognize her in her senior year as an Allstate musician. Also on the stage, we've got Alexis Russell, Anna Helinski, and Kristen Rainwater, who are all seniors as well, and Tommy Downey, who is a junior. And they're all fantastic players, and I'm so glad to have all of them in my program. So I hope you enjoy Symphony Espanol. Thank you. right, so at this time, I'm going to invite Megan McGinnity to come up and speak to you a little bit more about why it is important to protect the Chesapeake Bay as our 11th and 12th grade string students make their way up on stage. So 11th and 12th graders, please come up quietly. You could go up that direction. That would be a good idea. And Megan will be right here.
Good evening. As one of the largest and most productive estuaries in the world, the Chesapeake Bay plays a key role in the environment and is important to protect. The Chesapeake Bay watershed spans several states, providing drinking water and recreational activities to millions of people, along with supporting key industries such as fishing. The bay's ecosystem includes diverse habitats that support thousands of plant and animal species. As the bay's health begins to decline, its services to us deteriorate as well. The only way to preserve the rich biodiversity and benefits of the Chesapeake Bay is to protect its health. Thank you.
The first piece we're going to perform for you as they're getting situated is To Tame the Raging Rapids. This is a little bit of a flip-flop of the program. So To Tame the Raging Rapids is this one. Russian Sailors is next. I messed it up a little bit. Sorry. But this is by an actual local Baltimore composer, Ryan Balmages. And so this piece depicts the beauty and the power of nature. It was first written about an experience that Ryan Balmages had, or a friend had, when he was rock climbing in Great Falls outside Washington, D.C. His friend ended up falling into the water and he had to be rescued by a nearby kayaker. And luckily everything was okay, but it just reminded him how dangerous water can be sometimes, even though it's beautiful. So this piece juxtaposes the beauty of water with its lethal power and cautions listeners to respect the power of nature. So here is To Tame the Raging Rapids.
Thank you.
we have for you is one of the favorites of the students. It's one that we played at assessments this year, and I am happy to say that we got all ones at our assessment this year, so congratulations. So this next piece is called Russian Sailor's Dance. It is from a originally from a ballet, but as you can imagine, it is sort of like a Russian dance, and so that's where it gets its name. The tempo kind of gradually progresses throughout the piece, just like when you, generally a lot of Russian dances will do the same thing, so that's where the tie-in happens. I did want to say if there's, so we had a couple 10th and 11th, no, 9th and 10th, I think it was just 10th graders, but a few other extra students who aren't in this class join us at assessments, so if you guys would like to come up here and play along, you are welcome to. If you want to just watch, you don't have to, but I thought I would invite you if you'd like to. Kiyomi's like, where's everyone going? Like, is anyone coming? You can come up, Kiyomi. You can share. I put them on the spot. They don't have to. Oh, there we go. All right.
Thank you.
All right, we are very privileged here at Seabill and Wright to have so many amazing wind players in addition to our string players. So at this time, we're gonna add some winds to our orchestra. So come on up. We're also going to have Lauren Tuman speak to us a little bit more about the bay. So wind players, please try to be quiet as you're taking your seats on stage.
Hi everyone. So as we report tonight, there are many ways, many reasons why we should protect Chesapeake Bay. There are many reasons such as planting trees by the shoreline of the bay. Planting trees will help filter out the harmful pollutants that are often carried in by the runoff. They also provide a habitat for the animals we call the Chesapeake Bay home. We can also participate in cleanup days to remove litter from areas surrounding the shoreline. Clean the Bay Day, hosted by the Chesapeake Bay Foundation, is a great opportunity to volunteer to reduce the harmful litter and debris. But of course, if you're not into getting your hands dirty, there's still ways to support the Chesapeake Bay. Purchasing a $20 Treasure of the Bay license plate is an easy way to help. Over half the cost of the license plate will go towards supplying education and restoration efforts. I hope you consider taking part in one of these options, and thank you all for the generous donations made tonight. They're greatly appreciated.
So this is our last piece for you today, but we do have some awards and senior recognitions and lots of fun stuff to get to after the concert. So stick around for that. But our last piece for you today is Warrior Legacy. Like I said, we have some lovely wind players here at Seamilton Wright. So they are joining us for this piece to create a full orchestra, which is something that we don't often get to do. So it's very exciting. This piece is by a living composer named Soonhee Newbold, and it was commissioned for an orchestra in Fairhaven, Massachusetts, and it's all about the history of Fairhaven. So from the time the English settlers purchased the land to all the sea battles that took place during the Revolutionary War, and the whaling culture that is a big part of Fairhaven, which actually inspired Herman Melville to write Moby Dick. So the students and I think it sounds like a pirate piece, so we really like it. But the reason it sounds that way is because it's depicting all of these sea battles that happened off of the coast of Massachusetts. So we hope you enjoy. Oh my gosh, hope you enjoy our last piece. I have a lot more talking to do, so this is not bode well for me. Okay, hope you enjoy our last piece, Warrior Legacy.
Thank you.
recognize, and a few goodies to give out, so very important. First of all, I would like to recognize the students who were involved in the Pitt Orchestra this year for Sister Act. It's a huge extra time commitment. So I have beautiful medals for the Pitt Orchestra musicians. So when I call your name, if you're in Pitt Orchestra, could you please come down and receive your medal? So Connor Albin, Anna Holinsky, Amelie Marasigan, and Alexis Russell. Come on down. Personally, in about, I don't know, 15 minutes when we're done. Okay. We also have some all-county orchestra students to recognize. Please tell me if I forgot anyone again. I'm so sorry. all-county orchestra, we also have medals for you, but they were supposed to be delivered today, and then they took them back because I guess there was no one in the office to receive them, so I will get them to you as soon as possible, I promise, but for right now, you're just going to stand up, and we're all going to cheer for you. So these students auditioned for and made all-county orchestra. I'm including the wind players in this as well. So go ahead and stand up when you hear your name, and we will clap for all of them at the end. So here are the string players who made all-county orchestra: Amelie Marasigan, Thomas Dragunas, Alexis Russell, Anna Holinsky, Kiyomi Tan, Carly Gaynor, Kristen Rainwater, Alex Curry, and our wind players, Caitlin Goldberg, Reese Marasigan, Anne Newberry, Nick Anderson, Josh Lefter, Nick Sprague, Addison Sweat, Greg Pridgen, and Ben Rowland. They're not all here tonight, but for those of them that are here, let's give them a big round of applause. Evelyn Lockhart. rainwater. Maddie Reinhart is not here tonight, but she is another one of our seniors. And Alexis Russell. Tara Singh, who's not here tonight either, but another one of our seniors. Amy Whipple. It's on the list, and I skipped over it. Kenny Matthews, come on up. Okay, did I skip anyone? Okay, you were on the list. I just skipped over one of it. I swear I put it in here. Okay. We have a few awards to give out. I have four awards to give out to some seniors. And then we have our senior slideshow for some pictures over the years and that kind of stuff. There will be tears and crying and whatnot, but that's it for a little bit. Yes. Oh, Kristen would like to say something real quick, and then we'll do our awards.
Okay, so I just wanted to say, us seniors really appreciate having you. Most of us, on average, have had 7 or 8 orchestra teachers in my entire music career. You are this one who stayed with us the longest. And we wanted to do something really nice with you. It's not here yet, but you do have a new Mallard baton coming.
Whoa, thank you.
And a case.
Thank you guys, that's so sweet.
I really appreciate it.
Okay, I got my notes here. Here we go. Okay, so I have 4 awards to give out tonight before our slideshow. The first one is the Instrumentalist Magazine Merit Award. This award recognizes students who have shown outstanding contributions in leadership and service to the school music program. The recipient of this award has exhibited dedication to their instrument and our program. They have participated in orchestra all 4 years of high school and have also been a member of chamber orchestra, all-county orchestra, pit orchestra, and a section leader. They are always responsible in learning their music and extremely focused in rehearsal. The student is also a great leader, leading by example and with her musicality. I had the pleasure of getting to play with the student in pit orchestra this year, and she always kept me on track. She was always counting, even when I wasn't, because she's so much more responsible than me. So it has been such a pleasure having her in our program. This merit award goes to Alexis Russell. Instrumentalist Magazine Musicianship Award, which recognizes students who have shown outstanding musicianship and distinguished musical excellence. The recipient of this award has been in orchestra all 4 years of high school. They have also participated in all-county orchestra, chamber orchestra, and color guard, and have acted as a mentor for the 9th and 10th grade orchestra. They're also a member of Tri-M. This student has been a leader in their section for a long time and demonstrates great musicianship skills. She is passionate about her instrument, and frequently shares ideas on how to make her group better. This musicianship award goes to Kristen Rainwater. The next award is the C. Milton Wright Orchestra Award, C. Milton Wright School Orchestra Award. I don't have a certificate for this award, but the recipient will receive a certificate at the school award ceremony, so it's technically supposed to be secret, so none of you can tell anybody. But this award goes to a student that has gone above and beyond to participate in and make the C. Milton Wright Music Department a better place. The student will receive a certificate and have their name added to a plaque that will hang in the hallway of the music department for years to come. The recipient of this award has been in orchestra all 4 years of high school. They have also participated in all-county orchestra, chamber orchestra, pit orchestra, color guard, and are a member of Tri-M. The student is always ready and excited to be involved in any music activity we have at C. Milton Wright. She's been a huge asset to our program, and her enthusiasm inspires others to get involved. Anytime I need somebody to play for an event or complete a task for me, she's always the first to volunteer. She's spent lots of time after school showing her dedication to our program. She's always enthusiastic in rehearsals and willing to go above and beyond to make our program better. This year's C. Milton Wright Orchestra Award goes to Anna Holinsky. National School Orchestra Award. This award is the highest honor you can bestow upon a member of the high school orchestra. The recipient of this award will receive a certificate and have their name added to a plaque that will hang in the hallway of the music department for years to come. The recipient of this award has participated in an orchestra all 4 years of high school. They have been involved in chamber orchestra, all county orchestra, all state orchestra, Pitt Orchestra, and Hartford Youth Symphony. She has also acted as a mentor for the 9th and 10th grade orchestra. This student has shown exemplary musicianship over the years. She's an incredible violinist and very dedicated to her instrument as well as our program. She's always willing to help other students by leading sectionals or giving lessons. The student is so kind and giving, and her willingness to be involved and help others improve is very inspiring. It's been such a pleasure having the student in my program over the years, and I know she'll do amazing things in the future. This year's National School Orchestra Award goes to Amelie Marcy. Senior slideshow. So if the people up there in the booth could pull that up for us. We're all going to watch the slideshow. Students, can you guys see this? Okay. Do you want to go sit in your seats instead? Okay, good. Why don't you go sit in your seats so you can see, and then we'll get it started for you. And then if we could turn the stage lights down a little bit maybe too. Oh, that's it. That's the way. All right, here we go. Thank you.
take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you build a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your own name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love, and it hurts so bad.
Thank you.
You did it. You made it through your last spring concert and your senior slideshow. It has been such a pleasure having all of you in orchestra the past 3 years. It's been amazing. Before we go, I just want to say thank you to our administrators. Thank you so much for supporting us. Thank you to Dr. Frisch and Mr. Karolenko for helping me set up for the concert. Thank you to the students for doing such a wonderful job. And students, please thank your parents for supporting you and helping you do music. Seniors, for so many years now, a lot of you have been playing, so please give your parents a round of applause. All right, that's all, folks. I hope you have a lovely night. Aw, thank you. Don't forget, on your way out, you can make a donation to the Chesapeake Bay Foundation if you feel so inclined. We would really appreciate it. Have a great night, everybody.